So the reply has been tabled by the House.
Supplementary.
Thank you, sir. The cryptocurrencies have been compared to the pyramid schemes and the economic bubbles, which have affected a lot of people who joined that. So I'd like to know whether there are any consumer protection available to the people who are already using cryptocurrencies. And some agency says that they will accept bitcoins. So what is the government planning to protect people?
Minister. December 24, 2013, both the Reserve Bank of India and the Government of India have consistently maintained a position and have made it public repeatedly that this is not a lawful legal tender in India, and therefore that protection is not available. It is operating online. That's a separate matter. There have been expert groups which have been set up how to deal with this situation, whose report is now awaited. But this is not a legal tender, and this is the clear position which has been set out even recently, as late as the 29th of December by the Government of India in its press release. So from 2013 to 2017, this has consistently been the position of both the central bank and the government.
Second supplementary.
Whether the government is aware of the threat of cryptocurrencies being used for illegal purposes, and it's been found that some terrorist groups are also finding it very convenient to use these bitcoins. So what are the measures taken by the government to stop this? And I also like to know if they have any data on the crimes.
Minister.
Sir, one of the features of cryptocurrency has been that there is a lack of dependence on the state, and that this functions with a certain amount of anonymity. It functions within the virtual community which is created and enjoys the trust of that virtual community itself. Now, it operates online through blogs, it operates through WhatsApp groups, etc. And there are several kinds of cryptocurrencies. In fact, there are all over the world 785 virtual currencies which are today in operation. And there are about 11 such exchanges which have been online identified in India. There was an interdepartmental committee which was set up in the year 2016 that examined the matter, and that decided that certain cautions be taken and people at different levels be given a caution or a warning, those who engage in this activity, that there is no lawful protection, which was accordingly done. And now how in future it is to be dealt with in India, there is an expert group under the Secretary, Department of Economic Affairs, which is functioning, whose report is now awaited.
Thank you. Sri Raju Chandrasekhar.
I find that cryptocurrencies are not legal tender, and I'm assuming he also means that it is therefore illegal. Would he consider an immediate direction to banks, credit cards, etc., while the committee is still doing its report, to prohibit purchases and transactions in cryptocurrencies with immediate effect?
The government is awaiting the report of the expert group as to what are the steps to be taken. And the reason being that there are such large number, as I mentioned, cryptocurrencies globally which are operating, and they can operate from any part of the world because they virtually operate in the virtual group itself. And therefore, rather than take any knee-jerk reactions immediately, we are awaiting for that report, and once that report comes, only then the measured steps which are to be taken in this regard will be taken.
Sri Amar Singh.
धन्यवाद अध्यक्ष महोदय जी. मैं आपके माध्यम से माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी से पूछना चाहूँगा कि बिना नाम लिए कहना चाहूँगा कि बहुत बड़े बड़े लोग जो करोड़ों रुपया कमाते हैं प्रचार से, वो लोग भी बिटकॉइन के धंधे में शामिल हैं. उनके नाम पनामा और पराडाई जैसे स्कैंडल में भी आए हैं. हमारे पड़ोसी देश में आप कहते हैं कि लीगल टेंडर नहीं है, यानी जाली नोट की तरह है. और बगल के देश में और विश्व के कई देशों के राष्ट्राध्यक्ष वो अपना पद खो बैठे हैं, लेकिन न पनामा में कुछ होता है, न पराडाइज में कुछ होता है,
सवाल
सवाल में कुछ होता है. क्या कोई प्यूनिटिव एक्शन ऐसे लोगों के विरुद्ध लेने की आप कृपा करेंगे, या कोई प्रावधान ऐसा बना रहे हैं, या कमेटी के रिपोर्ट की प्रतीक्षा में?
ठीक, मंत्री जी.
सभापति जी, ये दोनों विषय अलग अलग हैं. जहां तक पनामा और पैराडाइज का विषय है, उसमें जिन लोगों के या जिन एंटिटीज के नाम उसमें आए थे उसके संबंध में एकदम उपयुक्त जांच भी हुई है, और उनमें से जिन लोगों के अकाउंट्स गैर कानूनी उसमें पाए गए उनके खिलाफ जो जो कार्रवाई कानून में यानी एडजुडिकेशन असेसमेंट क्रिमिनल लॉ एक्शन इत्यादि है वो कार्रवाई उनके खिलाफ उन कानूनों के हिसाब से हो रही है। जहां तक बिटकॉइन का सवाल है, क्योंकि ये पूरे विश्व के अंदर एक नई परिस्थिति पैदा हुई है और केवल भारत की से सामने चुनौती नहीं है, तो पूरे विश्व का अनुभव भी देखते हुए भारत ने इसको किस तरीके से निपटना है इसके संबंध में, जैसा मैंने कहा कि पहले प्रश्न के उत्तर में, अध्ययन सरकार इस विषय में कर रही है कि क्या कार्रवाई कर सकते हैं।
श्री आनंद भास्कर अपोलो।